Beste kijkers, goeiedag. Welkom bij alweer de 5e aflevering van ZZ Leiden TV. Het studioprogramma over basketbal van Zorg en Zekerheid Leiden. Hier in de schitterende studio van Sleutelstad. We hebben weer een bomvolle basketbalweek achter de rug. En ook succesvol voor Leiden, want ze zijn nog steeds ongeslagen. 6 gewonnen, niks verloren in de DBL. En het begon op afgelopen woensdag, namelijk tegen de Hague Royals. De nieuwkomer werd ingepakt in de 5 meihal 90-64. Maar toen, zondag, Valentijnsdag, in Rotterdam, was het een stuk moeilijker. Leiden stond de hele tijd voor, maar op het laatst werd het nog zeer, zeer spannend tegen Feyenoord. Maar Leiden won met 84-87. Er is even geen competitiebasketbal. Pas weer op de 27e februari speelt Leiden meteen ook weer thuis tegen Almere Sailors. En die periode wordt ingevuld door Oranje, want het Nederlands team heeft een hele belangrijke window in Turkije om zich te plaatsen voor het EK van volgend jaar. De onderwerpen in deze aflevering. We gaan straks eerst kijken naar de samenvatting van die spannende wedstrijd in Rotterdam tussen ZZ Leiden en Feyenoord. Daarna is hier te gast, op deze stoel, Riley Lechance, de nieuwe guard die al meteen zo goed speelde tegen Feyenoord. Vervolgens hebben we een mooi videoprofiel en analyse van de laatste nieuwe aanwinst. Ja, ja, net vandaag bekendgemaakt. De nieuwe forward Nick King gaan wij doornemen. De uitzending gaan wij afsluiten met een nieuw onderdeel, namelijk de quiz. Met een hele bijzondere vraag en er is een voucher te winnen voor de livestream. Dus u kunt meespelen en e-mailen, dat leggen we aan het einde uit. Maar we gaan nu eerst naar de samenvatting van Zorg en Zekerheid Leiden uit tegen Rotterdam. Hier in de beelden uit het topsportcentrum Rotterdam onder de rook van de Kuip, waar tegelijkertijd overigens werd gevoetbald. En Leiden met niet inzetbaar Michael Finke, hij is nog geblesseerd en hetzelfde geldt voor Troy Koeler. Maar de guard, de nieuwe man Riley Lechance, hij mocht wel spelen. Dus we gaan hem zien in deze wedstrijd. Leiden opende met Marijn Ververs, Giddy Potts, Rudy de Jong, Luc van Bree en Emmanuel Enzekwesi. Ja, ze hadden misschien nog die wedstrijd van oktober in gedachten, waar ze geen schijn van kans maakten tegen Feyenoord. En Leiden begon meteen scherp. Een drietje zagen we al van Luc van Bree. Ook Rudy de Jong speelde uitstekend. 3-punters, een dunk. En wat dat betreft gewoon een prima start van Leiden dat al snel op 9-16 voorkwam. Nou heeft Feyenoord ook een prima basis 5 en vooral Mac Bruining en Arunas Mikalauskas lieten zich gelden in die beginfase. Riley Lechance komt dan in het veld bij Leiden en gooit er al gauw zijn eerste score in, dat is lekker. Emmanuel Enzekwesi liet zich ook zien, een driepuntertje van Giddy Potts eroverheen en prima eerste kwart, 22-32. Nou, en in het tweede kwart nog steeds een hele goede fase van Leiden. Een lekkere end-one van Mees van het Hof. Nog een score van Lechance. Maar dan toch enige slordigheden. Even een time-out van hoofdcoach Geert Hamming. Leiden 6 punten voor op dat moment. En Lechance met een prima reactie, een 3-punter. Rotterdam hangt in de wedstrijd, schommelt zo rond een puntje of 6. Jeroen van der List, ex-Leiden, maakt een mooie actie en dan nog een score van Lechance. De ruststand 43-51. Ja, en dat verschil bleef eigenlijk een hele tijd zo. Iedere keer dat Rotterdam een beetje terugkwam, gaf Leiden weer even gas. En Enzekwesi speelde een goede fase. De Jong, Potts en Lechance. Ook goede afstandsschoten van Leiden. En met nog één kwart te gaan, Leiden gewoon 10 punten voor. Lechance blijft lekker doorscoren. Mooie scoren via het bord. Dan een onsportieve fout van Rydell de Pre, afgestraft door de Jong met 2 vrije worpen. En ook nog eens een 3-punter eroverheen van Enzekwesi. En dan staat Leiden maar liefst 17 punten voor. Maar toen kantelde de wedstrijd. Vooral kwam Leiden nauwelijks meer tot scoren. Want in die laatste 7 minuten tot aan de laatste minuut zagen we alleen field goals van Lechance en Enzekwesi. En Rotterdam zat op een enorme run van 22-4 en kwamen zelfs 1 puntje voor. En ook de enige keer in de wedstrijd op 83-82. Ververs met een keurig schotje. Hij haalt de voorsprong weer terug naar Leiden. Vervolgens een goede verdedigende actie van Leiden. 24 seconden overtreding van Rotterdam. En dan is het de Jong die een vrijworpen benut. Leiden plus 2. dan kan Mikolauskas voor Feyenoord de vrije worpen nemen. En hij benut de eerste, maar niet de tweede. Tip in van Van der List lukt ook niet. En dan komt de bal bij Pots. Hij wordt gefould en mag ook nog vrije worpen nemen. Zet Leiden op +3. En dan op het allerlaatste moment nog een wanhoopschot van Van der List dat niks raakt. En Leiden wint dus. Zij het nipt. Ze gaan door het oog van de naald 84-87. Over de hele wedstrijd gezien, hele mooie cijfers weer van Emmanuel Nzikwesi. 24 punten, 12 rebounds. Mooie allround game van Woody de Jong. 19 punten, 8 rebounds, 7 assists en ook nog 3 steals. En de debuterende Riley Lechance. 15 punten met een prima schotpercentage van 55%. Ja, hij is hier aangeschoven in onze studio, de nieuwe guard Riley Lechance. Welcome Riley, good to see you.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for being here. I'm excited to be here.
I heard that that was like almost a year ago that you played your last official game. Is that true?
Yeah, I think just over 11 months ago. I think my last game in Belgium was like March 12th or 13th or something like that. So coming up on a year, yeah.
So you had your debut in Rotterdam.
Yep.
with the win yesterday.
Yeah.
How was that to finally play again after so many months?
Yeah, I mean, it was a great feeling. I was just excited to get back out there, play with the guys, be in the team atmosphere. And we like to make it interesting at the end, I guess, but it felt really good to be back out there.
Well, and it showed, because I think, you were in for a few seconds and you made your first basket, it feels good probably.
Yeah, I mean, it felt really good. I felt like I got into a good rhythm early, and my teammates made it really easy for me to, being the new guy jumping in, and they've been great so far, so they make it really easy for me.
You just mentioned your last game in Belgium. You played on the same team as Clayton Vetti, you told me.
Yeah, I played with Clayton last year, and I know he played here a couple years ago. And, when I told him I was coming here, he kind of gave me the rundown. And, so definitely love Clayton, and I know he loved playing here too.
Did you know anything else about ZZ Leiden before you signed? Did you hear from guys or research a bit?
I actually ended up watching a couple games last year. When I was hanging out with Clayton, we would tune into a couple games when we weren't playing. So I knew a little bit about it, and I know it's a historic club in Holland, and knew it's a well-respected club. So when I heard I had the opportunity to possibly play here, I was excited about it.
That's interesting to hear. So you guys were playing in Belgium, you had some time off, and then you were watching the Dutch league.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Well, cool. I think one night we watched a game or two, or two or three games.
That's cool. If I'm well informed, you're from Wisconsin.
Correct. Yep.
So we had like a few inches of snow, and everybody's like, "Oh, this is the worst winter, in decades." And how was that for you? Because I think you laugh about that, right?
Yeah. Well, actually, like two nights before I left, we had a huge snowstorm. And there was a ton of snow, and I feel like I kind of brought the bad weather with me, so I apologize for that. But I'm used to it at this point, so this is really nothing for me.
Near what city that we might know in Wisconsin are you from?
I'm like 20 minutes outside of Milwaukee.
Okay.
So and then I'm like Chicago, Illinois. I'm like an hour and a half from that, so not too far.
Are you a Bucks fan?
I am, yeah. Uh-huh. I am, yep.
I think this year they still need to find their groove a bit, right?
Yeah, they've struggled a little bit this year, and obviously last couple years have been pretty disappointing endings, but hopefully they can figure it out down the stretch this year.
If you want to have a nice conversation, you should ask Worthy the time he played against Giannis.
Oh, really?
The Eurobasket, yeah. They played against each other.
Yeah, I bet that, that's crazy.
That's 6 years ago, yeah.
Yeah.
So we talked about Clayton Vetti, but we understood that you also know Carrington Love.
Yeah.
What's
the
story?
So I Carrington, we're from near each other, and we actually have the same trainer back home and work out. In the summer we work out pretty much every day together. So I know he was out here, and he kind of gave me the whole rundown on how it was, and I know he liked being out here, and I'm real close with him.
And did you ask his advice, should I sign, what should I, look for?
Yeah, and he gave me a bunch of stuff to be aware of, and he told me, he played in Belgium as well, so he was giving me the rundown on how Belgium and Holland very similar, and so he definitely gave me some good advice on before I came out here.
Well, let's do another player, because we were talking before the show that, you know, there's this network, players know one another.
Yeah.
There's a new guy coming on the team, Nick King.
Yeah.
You know him too?
Yeah, and actually in Giddy, Giddy Potts, they were on the same team in a little while for college, and I was able to play against them. They went to school about 40 minutes from me in Tennessee, so we actually played them twice. So yeah, very familiar with them too.
To us, it seems like, well, of course, basketball is huge in the States,
but right.
at the same time, you make it seem like, you know, it's really well connected and players really,
yeah,
it's a small family. You
know? Yeah, it's kind of crazy how all the connections I've, had with some of the guys on the team here. Definitely rare.
Well, let's do a final one. Michael Finke.
Yeah. Yeah, so Mike, I actually grew up playing basketball on the travel circuit against him for years. And, you know, so he was always the best player on this one team we always played. And then fast forward a couple years in college, he was considering transferring to Vanderbilt, my university. And he came to campus and I showed him around a little bit and stuff like that. So definitely, you know, and then I've, like I said, when we were younger, I felt like I was playing against him every weekend. So definitely very familiar with Mike.
Would you say that might help you to integrate into the team now, even though this was, you know, several years ago?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, there's definitely some common ground there between all of us. And like I said, they've, you know, those guys as well as everybody else on the team have been very welcoming, and they've made it a really easy transition for me.
You share a house with another guy?
Or no, I'm by myself.
Oh,
by myself.
Oh, that's even better. Okay, good. So you mentioned Belgium before. Can you tell us a little bit about your pro career after college until now?
Yeah, so my first year I played in Poland, was out there for the whole season. And then second year I played in, last year I was in Belgium, in Aalst, and, you know, had a good season out there. And then obviously things got shut down in the middle of March. So I've been home in Wisconsin pretty much ever since then, just training and waiting for another opportunity. And now I'm here. Now I'm here in Leiden.
Yeah, we're really happy to have you. So we over the summer, we talked to a lot of players about, well, was it hard, you know, with COVID, with not being able to be the professional that you want to be, not
sure.
to be able to showcase your skills on the court. How was that for you?
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely tough, you know, especially, you know, for like we talked about earlier, I haven't played a game in 11 months. So, you know, I think there was a stretch there in, you know, December or, you know, November where, you know, I was starting to think, man, am I ever going to play again? Mm. And, you know, it definitely threw a wrench into things. There was a lot of uncertainty and obviously in the States too and within European basketball everywhere. So, you know, things were very uncertain and it was tough. And luckily we're, you know, in Wisconsin, things were open for the most part. So I was able to, and I've got a connection to kind of a private gym. So uh-huh. I was able to, you know, work out every day and, you know, get a little bit of a routine going. So that made it a little bit easier. And but, you know, definitely with the 11-month break was very unusual for me.
Well, happy to see you catch up in a way. You know,
yeah,
we have a lot
yeah,
of games coming up. So now a little break, of course, because of the national team.
Right.
Yeah, we mentioned briefly the game that you guys won against Feyenoord.
Yep.
Putting up a nice number of points. Then they made a run at the end. It got really close. Maybe, you know, defense needs to harmonize a bit, you know, learn to find each other. To me, you know, just as a viewer, it seemed the referees were pretty present. You know, sometimes some games you don't really notice them, and now it was like a lot of calls. Not to criticize that, but do you notice any difference maybe from how the game was called in, you know, overseas or in Belgium versus how it was yesterday?
Yeah, I mean, that's something that, you know, that we can't control. So I think, you know, like you said, some games they'll be, you know, maybe more physical than others. So, you know, that's something we can't control. We just have to adapt and, you know, be able to play however they're calling it. And we can't let that bother us or, you know, individually and as a team as well. So that's just something we got to play through and not worry about.
Yeah, agreed. Would there be any lesson to be drawn from that? From, okay, apparently they're, you know, calling this and that quite quickly. We should adapt to that, or is there something you can point
to? Yeah, I mean, I think I had, you know, we had two guys foul out. I had four fouls, and, you know, I think, you know, maybe we could have adapted a little quicker to the way they were calling the game. And, you know, they were calling it that way on both sides. So, you know, I think that was, you know, maybe an error on our part. We got to adapt a little bit quicker and not get so many guys in foul trouble.
We did a little analysis thanks to one of the great highlight videos we found from you on the previous show. But if you would describe yourself, how would you describe your game?
I think I'm kind of a true combo guard. You know, I feel like I'm comfortable playing the point guard or the shooting guard positions. You know, I'm really, obviously I'm proud of myself on being able to shoot the ball and, you know, but, you know, I'm willing and able to do, you know, whatever team needs or whatever coach asks of me. So, you know, if that's play point guard and be the main facilitator, I'm definitely willing to do that. So, you know, and then just try to contribute any way I can.
Would you be one of those guys, if you had to choose, you know, would you pride yourself on your offense or your defense?
You know, I think my defense is definitely something I need to improve on. So, you know, whether that's watching film or studying stuff more and, you know, getting in a rhythm on how we play defensively. So that's something I'm always trying to improve on from year to year and even game to game.
So you've been able to get a few practices in one game. Mm-hmm. What would be your first observations about how this team is coming together and what it's doing well?
Yeah, you know, obviously I think we have a really good team. You know, and obviously bringing in Nick now, we had another piece, and you know, Mike's been out the last couple of games, so hopefully with this national team break, we get him back healthy. You know, I think we got some really good pieces that fit really well together and complement each other. So we got some really good players, and you know, I can tell that, you know, we have a very unselfish team and guys who like to pass the ball and share the ball. And, mm-hmm. You know, I think that'll really help us offensively and down the road. And we got a lot of guys who can do, you know, a lot of different things. So I think we got something special, and you know, we just got to keep, or you know, we're off to a good start. And you know, once the national team break ends, we got to keep building on that.
Well, it's very good to see. You know, the team is unbeaten. We get the split on Elite A, Elite B. Well, mm-hmm. That should be a shoe-in, you know, going to the Elite A, and then you have a whole set of games to prepare for the playoffs. So you know. In other words, it feels like you, as a team, you still have time to come together to integrate you and Nick.
Yeah, for sure. And like I said, everybody's been really welcoming. And, you know, I think they've made the transition easy on me. So I know, you know, it'll be the same way for Nick. And, you know, once we get our full team back and, you know, guys come back from the national team. And, you know, I think we'll continue to build and hopefully make a run at a championship.
That would be awesome. What would be a point where in the short amount of time that you've been here, the team should improve on?
Kind of like I said, I think, you know, we're still learning about each other, what each other does well. And, you know, I think us being able to put a whole game together is really important. You know, I think you saw last game we got up 17 or 15 or 17 and they came right back and they even took the lead for a little while at the end. So. I think being able to put a whole game together and not play good in spurts, but play for a full 40 minutes, that's important going forward.
Yeah, great point. So, Riley, did I miss anything?
No, nothing I can think of.
I have one final question. That's maybe the most important one. We have a camera there.
Okay.
Exclusively for you, if you would like, to speak to our fans, because they're all watching on local TV, on YouTube.
Yeah.
They're getting to know you a bit. Anything you want to call out, anything you want to ask them, anything you want to tell them, you can do it right there.
Yeah. Hey fans, I'm obviously excited to be here. You know, you guys have been very welcoming. Everybody in the city, everybody in the organization has been welcoming. And, you know, even though we can't have you at games right now, you know, we're still thinking about you and playing for you. So we appreciate your support. I appreciate your support. And, you know, hopefully win some games going forward for you guys.
Ja, mooi om hem meteen te spreken, de nieuwe guard, Riley Lechance. Maar ja, er is dus nog een nieuwe speler. En dat is Nick King. Die is nog nieuwer dan Riley. En ja, hem zullen we ook binnenkort wel spreken. Maar voor nu hebben we alvast een videoanalyse gemaakt van de sterke punten in zijn spel. En die gaan we nu doornemen. Ja, hier dus Nick King met nummer 5 in actie. We beginnen met een aantal dunks vooral uit zijn collegeperiode. Speelde onder andere met Giddy Potts samen in de periode dat hij bij Middle Tennessee State speelde. En King is een, staat op Wikipedia als small forward, maar kan zeker ook op de 4 positie, dus de power forward zou je kunnen zeggen, uit de voeten wat dat betreft. Veelzijdige speler. En hij is 2 meter 3 en 102 kilo. Ja, atletisch, u ziet het hier, komt makkelijk van de grond. Goede lengte. Werd ook na zijn goede collegeperiode, waarin hij elk jaar beter werd, werd hij uitgeprobeerd in de NBA. Dat doen ze in de zogenaamde Summer League. En hij speelde daar niet voor de minste teams, namelijk voor de Lakers in de Summer League en ook voor de Celtics. En bij de Celtics liet hij een goede indruk achter. Speelde niet in de echte NBA, maar wel in de zogenaamde G-League. En dat is eigenlijk de opleidingsleague voor spelers en scheidsrechters en coaches van de NBA. Je ziet hier dat hij linkshandig is. En zijn profcarrière die begon hij op de Filipijnen. Basketbalgekke land overigens. Ook betrokken bij het eerstkomende WK. En daarna speelde hij in Colombia. Dat wil dus zeggen dat hij nog niet hier in Europa heeft gespeeld. En dat wordt dan dus zijn debuut als Europese speler voor Leiden. We zien hier ook dat hij van afstand uit de voeten kan. Hier ook weer rustig de 3 punten genomen. Dit zijn beelden uit die G-League. Uitwedstrijd hier in Portland ziet u voor de Maine Red Claws. Waarschijnlijk vanwege de kreeften die je daar in Massachusetts, in de buurt van Boston, hebt. Hier wat collegebeelden. Ja, kan driven, kan finishen met contact, kan rebounden. Dit zijn wat reboundacties van hem. Hier ziet u een tip in. Ja, dat wordt dan vaak gedaan in zo'n scouting video. Dan krijg je eerst wat dunks, dan wat passes, dan wat steals, et cetera, et cetera. En we zien hier dus dat die insight alert is. Ja, stevige beelden van de linkshandige nieuwe forward van ZZ Leiden. Dus Nick King, 25 jaar. En we kunnen niet wachten om hem te bewonderen. Te kijken hoe hij zich inpast in het team. Het laatste onderdeel van deze uitzending is een nieuw onderdeel. Namelijk de ZZ Leiden TV Quiz. En te winnen valt een voucher om gratis naar de livestream van 27 februari. En dat is tegen Almere Sailors te kijken. Best wel een pittige vraag, we gaan jullie een klein beetje helpen. Het gaat over spelers met in hun achternaam de letter Z van ZZ Leiden. In de hele periode dat ZZ Leiden bestaat, zijn dat er minstens 3 geweest. Met dus een letter Z in de achternaam. Nou, onze vraag is dus, wie zijn die 3 spelers? Maar misschien weet u wel meer dan 3 spelers. Dan moet u die natuurlijk ook aan ons doorgeven. De antwoorden kunt u mailen naar zzleidentv, gewoon helemaal aan elkaar, zzleidentv@gmail, dus met de letter g, gmail.com. En als er meerdere goede inzendingen zijn, dan gaat onze notaris loten voor die voucher voor de livestream. Hiermee zijn we aan het einde gekomen van deze uitzending. We zijn er natuurlijk volgende week weer. En voor deze keer hartelijk dank voor het kijken.